The search for Summer. Where is she? Heels on the ground.
For anybody that's sticking up for these despicable parents, shame on you and go straight to hell. Seriously. Why is he doing these things? Doesn't sound like a grieving father.
Candace and Don didn't even know Summer's birthday. That's shameful. Children when she was young, I believe around 20-ish, 19, 20-ish, the guy that she had these children with were twice her age. He was 44 at the time. And Candace Wells got arrested in Burnett County, Wisconsin, for abusing her child and drug use, which ultimately had her two children taken away from her from the state. Candace Wells has six mugshots in the state of Wisconsin. She's been arrested off and on back in the day for disorderly conducts and brandishing a weapon and her child abuse. So, you know, she gets her kids taken away. Now, we all know that people have reached out to her two children, and her daughter that she had out in Wisconsin said openly in Facebook groups on posts that during the last 20 years, 20 plus years since Candace had her children taken away, Candace has not reached out to her daughter once, not at all. She hasn't even attempted to build a relationship with her daughter or her son. She hasn't even reached them. Now we hear recently she tried to reach out to her daughter after backlash on that, but that's shameful. That's shameful. So her two kids are taken away. She joins the carnival. She's a carny girl, whatever. Hooks up with Don Wells and then goes to Don Wells' compound there on Ben Hill Road, Beach Creek. And then they breed more children. They breed three boys. And then Summer Wells, which, remember everyone, Candace and Don didn't even know Summer's birthday. They didn't even know Summer's birthday. During the course of the last 5 years, 911 calls that we obtained through Hawkins County, 911 dispatch, show continuous calls going to the Wells homes for domestic violence and the Wells giving alcohol to children and parents calling 911 saying their children are up there stuck at the Wells home and they're scared to go retrieve them because of the threats that Don and Candace have done. We've talked to numerous friends of Don and Candace Wells who said that Don and Candace gave their children alcohol.
So we have a question here. Some person that thinks they're smarter than you said, no, Candace was never charged with hurting her kids.
Yes, she was.
Yes, she was. And you want to know where we got the information? Directly from the state of Wisconsin.
We posted the criminal
documents. Through records requests.
It was in around 2001.
Maybe you should do your work. Maybe you should get off the internet and actually do, you know, records requests in the state of Wisconsin and read what this despicable woman has done.
She was arrested.
Multiple times. Multiple times she was arrested.
So that's a pattern in history of both of them. These are not, they're not victims. Don and Candace Wells are not victims. They're perpetrators.
Yeah.
They're predators.
They're predators.
They're perpetrators. They neglect children. They abuse children. They live a very just disgusting life there on Ben Hill Road. Their house that we've been to and saw up on the hill, it is littered with trash. Their property and their hill is littered with children's toys, beer bottles, garbage. Up at the top of their house, garbage. You have a school bus, an abandoned giant school bus on their property, along with old junk cars and a piece of crap trailer in back of their house. And you guys all saw the videos and pictures of the inside of the Wells home. It is a dump. And that's not an excuse because and you can't say poverty is an excuse, okay? Because I grew up poor, I really did. But I had personal pride. Even though you don't have the money, you still have personal pride in yourself. And they lack that. They lack that. We've listened to videos in the last 6 months, Don and Candace Wells fighting and arguing with each other on YouTube Lives, calling each other derogatory names. I mean, wake up, people. These people are not angels. They're not victims. They're disgusting people. And you have five-year-old Summer Wells. She's still missing. And they're not yet going out there searching for Summer Wells. They haven't even went on a search team for Summer Wells. They're not standing side by side with law enforcement for any reason. Why? Why isn't law enforcement standing next to Don and Candace Wells asking for, because they claim there was kidnapped, but no evidence. The police said no evidence. Authorities said no evidence of a kidnapping. Why isn't law enforcement next to Don and Candace Wells? I'll tell you why. Because they're guilty. They're guilty. They're past behaviors. Who would want to be next to them? Who would want to be able to be side by side with the Wells? Only bottom feeders and degenerates and disgusting people. They're like the people that, you know, they're kind. They're kind. We are not defending them. We are outing them. We will continue to expose them. Now, I offered an olive branch to Don Wells on Chronicles of Livia on her live earlier. I said, Don and Candace Wells, I'll put my differences aside. If you come out and lock arms with me, and we'll go search for Summer. Don Wells has been saying for the last week, oh, check the meth houses. You know, Summer's in the meth houses. It had to be a meth guy. Okay, Don Wells, well, come meet me, and we'll go check the meth houses together. I'll go knock on these doors. Show me which meth houses you think Summer is at so I can find Summer for you and bring closure. But you don't want to do that. Why, Don Wells? So I have no sympathy for this family. I doubt they will come out and meet us. I've offered that. Let's find Summer Wells. Let's get answers. And let's get justice.
Children's services as
Rogersville.
Well.
Rogersville.
In Rogersville. To do some sort of protest. You know, I know a lot of people were in here. Where's my mouse? We're in here asking us, you know, are we going to do that? It looks like if we have some time, we may be over there to protest them as well. Let them know we're watching and actually find out what in the world happened. Why were these kids not removed from this home? They had all the information. The first visit into this home that they ever saw was enough information to get those children pulled out of the home. Why did CPS fail them?
Yeah, well, so we're gonna actually, I'm gonna attempt to look for Sherry, or Mons, M-O-N-D-S, Mons. She is the actual case manager that is handling Don and Wells' custody case with the three boys. I'm actually gonna go and try to speak to her and present her documentation, photographs, and evidence that I feel child abuse occurred on the home of the Wells property. I want to reach her. I have that right to reach her. I have that right as a citizen to inform Tennessee Department of Children's Services whenever I feel that there's child abuse. And I have claim, you know, I have evidence to back that up. And I want to present it to them. I want to get it on the record. I want to talk to them. I want to talk to them about Don and Will, Candace Wells. I don't know if they're going to talk to me back because there is a gag order on their case. But I have the right to talk to them. And I have the right to hand them information.
Yeah.
That's what I'm going to keep doing, giving them information. I encourage everyone else, if you see Don and Candace Wells doing anything wrong to children, past behaviors, videos of them yelling at their children, spanking their children, pictures that are questionable, send them in to the Tennessee Department of Children's Services. Case Manager Mons, M-O-N-D-S, in that region, Rogersville, and let them know what Don and Candace Wells are doing. Because at this time, no child is safe on the Wells property. No child is safe there. I don't feel comfortable with the boys going back there. And I'm a citizen, and based off all their behaviors, I'm going to do everything in my possible, everything possible to prevent those kids from ever going back to that home again in those deplorable conditions. I'm trying to save the children.
Wells to help us, help them, and to help us go out and look for their five-year-old child that's missing. We're waiting to hear a response back from them. We hope they take us up on our request for them to help us find their child. So hopefully we'll get some responses from them, respectful to his daughter, Summer Wells, to be missing. And for him to be playing these little games and pranks, who does that? What parent does that?
You know, you know, pointing the fingers at other people as a diversion off of him. I mean, the other day he blamed Dudley Ajon, a coworker, and now he also blamed another coworker named Jerry McLean. Both of them worked or still work at Tucker Drywall, but he was blaming them, saying, oh, police need to check them. He was blaming his neighbor, Fred Hill, on Ben Hill. He points the fingers everywhere else, but he doesn't point the finger at himself. He doesn't accept any responsibility on himself. He's so adamant about a kidnapper, but cannot provide any details. Police are not backing him. He told us in text the other day that he has to turn himself in this Thursday, today, for a probation violation. He has to turn himself into probation. So was he lying? Was it just another lie?
I personally believe he was lying. I personally believe he's not turning himself in. I don't have, you know, that's the problem. He's too busy playing games than getting his butt up to help him, or to help find Summer. He's too busy playing games. And so, but at any rate, we did reach out and told him that we would put our biases, everything aside. If he would like to meet with us, if he would like to join arms with us, and if he would like to help us go find Summer Wells. And again, what person spends this much time playing games when they've had a child missing for 6 months? People that we come across that have children missing are distraught. They're not thinking about going on the computer. They're not thinking about going on YouTube. They're not thinking about playing games with people. They're not thinking about going out of their way to reach out to people to say that they're turning themselves in. They're not doing these types of things. They're just not. They're just not. These crocodile tears from Candace, why hasn't she been crying for the last 6 months? Why finally yesterday? Why? Why? You guys need to come out here. I mean, you literally feel the evil coming off Ben Hill Road.
Again.
Says, winter storm warning, drive carefully. We are in a winter storm on our way to find out what happened to Summer Wells.
Our requests are right now, they have enough to arrest both Candace Wells and Donald Wells on charges completely unrelated to Summer's disappearance, completely unrelated, that are within the statutes of limitations. And so we are trying to figure out why in the world these parents are still out and still able to use drugs and get drunk and, you know, live a free life when they are the primary persons of interest in their child's disappearance. So what we are proposing is that, you know, law enforcement look at what they currently have. We will be reading the incident reports out in front of TBI. You know, there's a lot of stuff there. A lot of stuff that's happened in the last, 18 months at that home that they can be arrested for. From child neglect, child abuse, child endangerment, animal abuse. Contributing to the delinquency of a minor, which they have, a pattern of behavior of doing. Multiple DUIs that Don Wells has never been arrested for. Clear violations of probation, before this last violation of probation, as well as since this new violation of probation in which he's going to court for. So we are really, trying to think outside the box, trying to be proactive in this case. I have little battery on this computer, so this is going to be a real short live. But we are here. We're, again, an hour away from our location. We're going to be with Marissa. We're going to sit down and discuss, you know, our strategy moving forward. We've got a lot of stuff to do tonight before tomorrow. And just wanted to let you guys know we're okay and still moving forward into the right direction. So how's everybody doing?
Forecast in Knoxville, Tennessee is a high of 27 degrees. We are going to stand outside in front of TBI in freezing cold weather, demanding justice and answers on what happened to Summer Wells. That's how dedicated we are here. You know, not many people would want to do that in the cold, in the freezing elements. But we want answers, and you know, we're invested in this. We're invested on finding answers on what happened to Summer Wells and hold the people responsible accountable and bring spotlight. We do not want Summer Wells' case to go cold. So while we're in the cold, we're gonna make sure the case remains hot, warm, in the spotlight. And that's what we're doing here.
Yep. Mm-hmm. So y'all, this is not an easy task. I can promise you, there's gonna be very limited people from YouTube. You know, they're always talking about us profiting off this YouTube, right? I doubt there's gonna be very many people from YouTube that are out there with us. And even the ones that show up, I can guarantee you, are not there for the long haul.
To do this weeks ago, and we did not expect the weather to be bad, because it's like, you know, it's almost snowing here. We're in a winter storm warning, but we didn't cancel our trip. We didn't let the weather deter us for our mission to find out what happened to Summer Wells. So I just want to emphasize that, you know, we're not scared of the weather. It could be 120 degrees, it could be zero. We will be out there looking for answers to find out what happened to Summer Wells. The public and the world deserves to know what happened to Summer Wells.